Hi and welcome to this A121 Acronair session. My name is Ola and I'm working as a field application engineer here at Acronair. We are really excited about releasing our new A121 radar, which has even better signal-to-noise ratio, improved range and power consumption. To make it easier for you to try it out, we have included this radar in an evaluation kit called A121 EVK. The kit consists of three boards, the XC120, XE121 and XS121. Today we will go through the following: hardware introduction, installation of Python and Expiration tool, flashing the XC120 with Expiration server, and Expiration tool demo. The XC121 evaluation board is intended to be used together with the XC120, a Raspberry Pi or an STM Nucleo 64-144 development board. The XC121 is equipped with one fixed A121 pulse coherent radar sensor, as well as four flat flexible cable connectors to which XS121 satellite boards can be connected. The flex cable solution enables a wide variety of use cases involving multiple radar sensors. It also facilitates proof of concepts, since the radar sensor board placement is not limited by the size of the evaluation board. It is not possible to run the XE121 without one of these MCU boards, since the XE121 is not equipped with an MCU. The purpose of the XE121 is to be able to evaluate the A121 pulse coherent radar sensor. This can be done in three different ways. The most straightforward and optimized way is to connect the XE121 to the XC120 connector board, which enables evaluation of the radar sensor using the Acronair Expiration tool. Connecting the XE121 to the XC120 gives you the highest data streaming rate thanks to the USB high-speed 2.0 connection on the XE120 and the high SPI speed that is possible to achieve when using the XE120 in combination with the XE121. The XE120 does not contain an A121 radar sensor and is intended to be used together with XE121. Without the XE121, the XE120 serves no purpose. The XE120 is delivered with a bootloader so that it can be flashed via the USB interface. If you prefer, you can connect the XE121 to a Raspberry Pi using the software development kit for Raspberry Pi. The rate at which you can retrieve data from the A121 is in this case limited by the Raspberry Pi SPI interface speed. The last option is to connect XE121 directly to an STM Nucleo 64 or Nucleo 144 development board featuring the MCU of your choice. The main reason for making XE121 compatible with the STM Nucleo development boards is to facilitate a software development using RC API. There is no support for this configuration in Acronair Expiration tool. Acronair provides the STM32 Cube IDE User Guide integration guideline to help you to get started. Everything is available at developer.acronair.com. The XS121 is a small satellite board equipped with an A121 pulse coherent radar sensor, which can be connected to XE121 via a flat flexible cable. It is not a mandatory component in the evaluation kit, but can come in handy when you want to evaluate multi-sensor use cases or a use case where space for sensor placement is limited. We also have lenses that fit to this EVK. LH120 contains a holder that fits to the XE121. It does not fit to XS121 though. If you want a lens to XS121, you need the LH112. Okay, now it's time to flash the XE120 with the Expiration server. Let's start by connecting XE121 with the XE120. Then we connect the USB-C cable. Please only use not a charge-only cable, and then we plug it into the computer. Now we download the software,
Head over to python.org/downloads and fetch the latest version. Follow the installation guide, but don't forget to add Python to the path. Open developer.akunir.com and log in. If you haven't registered an account, you have to do that first. Click on Software Downloads, followed by A121, XC120, and download the Expiration server. Once it's downloaded, unzip it. Head over to Akunir's page on GitHub and click on Akunir Python Expiration. There's a quick start for Windows, but since I'd like to have the video portable for those running Linux or Mac, I'll install it using pip. First, I create a new directory. This is not mandatory though. Alright, Python Expiration is up and running. Click the A121 icon. Since we've already connected our module, it should be seen. Press Flash and look for the file you just downloaded. Go ahead and flash it. Unfortunately, we have seen some issues with the Windows drivers, so let's go to the FAQ section on Akunir's GitHub page. It tells us to download Zadig. Let's use it to change the driver to WinUSB. Let's restart the Expiration tool. Press Connect, then choose your service of detector and then start the measurement.
Alright, now it's time for a demo. And that's all for today. Please don't hesitate to contact us if you have any issues.